And it's getting longer.
Uh-oh.
Oh, there we go. Which one is it? Stay with us, please. Father, to bless the choirs that come and sing, every singer, every special song, everything that's said and done inside this building today. Father, we'll give you the honor, we'll give you the glory and all the praise, for it's in Jesus' precious name we humbly pray. Amen.
Amen. All right, we'll have our secretary.
We have a total attendance this morning of 79.
Counting a little better. Yeah. All right, if there's nothing else, I'll turn over to Brother Rick.
All right, one more announcement. We're going to start doing our own cleaning here at the church, and all the money's been proceeds for that is going to go straight out to the building. We've decided to go a different route with the cleaning. The money that we have, straight to the building, okay? Everything that we can do there. Beth has placed the thing on the back if you want to sign up for volunteers. What we've asked is if at least maybe four people to attend, okay? And that'll make it a whole lot easier. It won't be a burden on anybody. It won't be hard on anybody. We got everything that you need, all the cleaning equipment, and we're going to sit down and have some things, what needs to be done, what needs to be cleaned or touched or whatever, and how it needs to be cleaned. But she's going to pick up the list after this afternoon at 3 o'clock, and we're going to start making some. So this week was taken care of, but we're going to start probably the next week, maybe two. It may be 2 weeks, but we're going to start here pretty soon. So you be much in prayer about that, and if you want to help, the sign-up sheet's back there on the table. Just sign up. If you want to wait and get a group of people together, four or five people, and hey, that make it a whole lot easier on cleaning. Amen? The more you have, the less you have to do. I say amen on that one. All right.
It's not only women.
It's not only women. It's men too. Amen? And don't say it don't fit. If your hand will fit on that fishing rod when you go fishing, it'll fit on that cleaner that we've got back. And you can't handle a heavy one because you got back problems. That ain't a problem. We got a little battery operated one back here we can put in your hand. It won't weigh nothing. Amen? Smile. That's supposed to be funny. But anyway, anybody that wants to help, we'd love to have you come be part of that. You'll stand with us. We'll go ahead and get our service started today. Before we do anything else, remember one thing. This altar's open. It's open the minute we walked inside the doors of this building, and it'll be open all the way up to the time we leave. So you be much in prayer. If you got a need today, you got a problem, situation you can't handle today, honey, we know somebody that can. His name is Jesus. Amen.
Yeah, amen.
So whatever you need today, let's just have a word of prayer. Brother Ivy, would you go ahead and introduce us in a word of prayer?
Thank
you.
Yes, Lord.
God, we thank you for the privilege of being here. Thank you, Lord. Bless the choir today. Bless each one in this building. Yes, Lord. God, have your way this morning.
Keep us in your care and watch over us and give us victory in everything we do by the amazing grace of God.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Everybody, we come on the choir.
Thank you.
There is a blood that calls the Bless them, Lord.
Thank you.
y'all pressed the one this morning. I want them to sing. She said she couldn't get up that high note. Valerie has got a beautiful voice. I want them to sing Jesus in the Mill or whatever the name of it is. Because he is.
Yes, he is.
All the time. He's right there in the middle.
Right.
Whatever you're doing, whatever you're going through, if you're just letting him, he'll be right there. Holding on to your hand, he'll go with you all the way to the end, as the preacher said all the time. All the way to the end, he'll be right there with you. He's right there with you everywhere you go, everywhere you turn. And I thank God that I've got a Savior that's alive and well.
Amen.
He's doing good. This COVID thing ain't bothered him. He ain't run around with a mask on. He's still alive and well right here. And I thank God for that Holy Ghost to come down and visit us right here. Well, I felt him this morning, didn't you? And I still feel him. And I got them old cold chills up there, but I tell you what, I'm about ready to fly away, you know? I love him this morning. I praise his sweet, precious name. God, I love him so much. He's been so good to me. I've been singing this song about 3 or 4 days now, so y'all pray for me.
What do you say?
But now I'm found so far away. But I'm home now. I once was lost, but now I'm found.
Yes.
Thank you.
And now my life so sings.
Yeah, come on
now. I once was blind.
If you would, to Ephesians chapter number 1. Ephesians chapter 1, I want you to look down at verse number 15 through verse number 22. If there's anything that I should have been doing inside this building today is worshiping and honoring God and praising the name of my Savior today,
yep,
because He's worthy to be honored and glorified in this building. The Bible said in verse number 15, He said, "Wherefore I also," watch this, "after I heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and love unto you all the saints, cease not." Amen? There's a cease not there. That means there's not a pause. There's not a break. There's not a time to take time.
Right.
Hey, I'm just taking some breaks, Lord. I'm just taking a little bit of time. I don't know if you're sitting here today and you've been taking a break on God. Honey, now's not a good time to take a break. We need God more now than we ever have.
Yeah.
And the world that we're living in right now and the troubles that we're faced with every day, I don't know about you. And I know that some people are sitting right here right now that you've gone through some things in your life just in the last few days, in the last few months, amen, in the last few years, that, hey, It's hard. But let me tell you, we need to hold on to the hand of God more now than we ever have. We need God more now than we ever have in our life. Inside this building right now, there's some people that God has touched their life and touched their hearts today. And we need to realize what God, He said, cease not. Hey, that means it's a non-stop thing of giving thanks to you,
yeah,
making mention of you in my prayer. Hey, there's one thing we can do if we can't do nothing else, and that's pray for each other.
No,
amen? And that's why Paul was telling the people in Ephesus that day, hey, they didn't think nobody cared. They got to a place they didn't think nobody loved them anymore. It seemed like they'd go to the altar and nobody would pray with them. And they'd call their neighbor and they wouldn't answer the phone. That's called phone screening. If you don't know what that is, the preacher's got that too. Say amen. Smile, that's supposed to be funny. But you know what? How many times have we called on God and God's always been there? Sometimes God just wants your voice. Sometimes God just wants you to be the one to call on His name. I need somebody to help me pray. If I'm going through something I've never been through in my life, I've got news for you. Hey, I need somebody to pray with me. I want you to pray with me. Hey, let's pray about that thing. He said, I cease not to give thanks and to continual prayer. But verse 17 said that God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom. Amen. You want to know how to get wiser in the Lord? There it is right there, honey. That's the way you can get wiser in the Lord. Let God be the one that put that wisdom down inside you today. I just knew the day I got saved that God was going to drill a hole right in the top of my head and just dump everything right there inside. Boy, wouldn't that be nice? Amen. I wouldn't have to study at all. I wouldn't ever, but that's why we didn't do it. That's why He did not do it. He knew what we would do. Oh, we'd lax back and get lazy. Hey, I need to study the Bible more.
Yeah.
Hey, I need to get in God's Word more. We need to pray more. More than we ever have. Well, if we'd have had all that dumped in our head, hey, we never would. We'd have got lazy on God. But thank God, God made it the way He did.
Amen.
He gave you the spirit of wisdom and the revelation of knowledge of Him. I don't know about you, but I need to know more about Him.
Yeah.
Don't you? I want to know more about my God, more than I know now. I know a lot of things about God. I know what God can do. I've seen the miracles that God has performed in this life. I've seen God do some mighty, wonderful work. I've seen God save some people's life and save their soul and save their home and save their job. I've seen God do an awful lot of things, but honey, I haven't learned it all yet. There's still some things to learn about God today, and it's about praise and honor and knowing Him today. The eyes of your understanding. That's what I need opened up today.
Amen.
Sometimes we walk around with our eyes closed and we don't recognize the blessings of God in our life. That's why sometimes we don't come and we don't worship and we don't pray and we don't thank God for what He's done in our life. Sometimes that eye of understanding has been closed shut and we're not looking around. Hey, you're here today and you're breathing today. You're on this side of the dirt today. Thank God you are. Amen. Thank God God's blessed you today and blessed your life today. Hey, thank God today He earns it. I owe Him my everything this morning. But the Bible teaches us today. The Bible said, eyes of your understanding. Hey, I don't know about you, but I need some enlightening today. I need God to open my eyes and let me see. Preacher, your eyes are open, but sometimes it gets a cloudy feel.
Oh,
you ever been there? I had that surgery. And let me tell you, I used to wear glasses when I was about 3 years old. I wore glasses all the way up to about 10 years ago when I had that, maybe a little less. But I had that surgery done. I couldn't see. I'd get out there at nighttime. All I could see was a bright light. That was it. Don't that make you scared? Amen? That ought to scare every one of you to death. I might have been driving on the same road you did. Say amen. I couldn't recognize a car from a truck. I couldn't recognize the color of the light, even though I picked running through the red light when I did. Say amen. You've done it too. Amen. Don't look mad at me like that. You've done it. But you know what? I couldn't see. But thank God I went and had some
some surgery done. I never put glasses on from the day they came. Hey, and it messed me up. He said, I'll do this 1 week, and we'll do the other in the other week. I had to walk around like this for a whole week because I could see with one eye and still blind in the other eye. But thank God, God opened my eye. I need him to open my spiritual eye. I need him to open my eyes of spiritual understanding today. And maybe you do too. Maybe you've been going through some things today, and you're going through some hardships in your life. Well, let me tell you, the best place to stay is take it to God and let God help you with it today. He's the only one that can help you through this situation today. The Bible said, what is the hope of his calling? And what the riches of his glory, of the inheritance of the saints? Verse 19, and what is the exceeding greatness. Amen. What is the greatness of God? Hey, just God being with you today, isn't that great enough? Knowing that God's with me everywhere that I go. He travels with me everywhere that I go. Every time, hey, when I was in the hospital and I had them surgeons coming around, God was right there with me, holding my hand. Say amen. He's always there. When I went to the funeral home and buried some family, let me tell you, God was right there and he was there holding my hand. He said, I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you. I'll go with you all the way to the end of the world.
Amen, bro.
And I trust him for that, don't you? Hey, there's some power today that we need to realize. What exceeding greatness of his power toward us. There's a power that's been made manifest in your life. There's a power that you have that you can call on anytime. It's called prayer. Thank God I can call on God in prayer anywhere. Thank God when I came to church and I couldn't get in the door, what am I going to do? How am I going to get a hold of God? I'm going through some things in my life that I don't understand. I'll tell you how. You can pray anywhere that you are. Anywhere. You can talk to the God. Hey, God the Father, he's listening. He'll listen to every word you have to say. That doesn't mean he's going to answer right now. How many times we expected the answer? Man, when I want something, I want it now. Don't you? That's the way we are. But you know what? Sometimes we have to wait on God. The Bible said be patient and wait on the Lord. Yeah. He's got it in his timing today. Maybe you need to ask the Lord today to make it your time today. Lord, I need you to touch some things in my life. There's some areas in my life need some enlightening. Lord, there's some things that I've gone through. I don't understand. I don't know why I've gone through all the things that I've gone through in my life. But God does.
Amen.
And God understands your heart. He knows your broken heart. Well, Jesus knows exactly what you've been through. He's had people turn his back on him. Hey, God the Father turned his back on his only begotten Son that day when he was on the cross of Calvary. My Bible said God literally turned his back on the Son of God. Why? Because of the sin that was laid upon his charge. Hey, he didn't sin. It wasn't his sin, honey. It was your sin. Yeah. It was my sin. That's what nailed Jesus on that cross.
Bless him, Lord.
But God turned his back one time. And guess what? Jesus said, I'll never turn my back on anyone. I don't know what you're going through today. I don't know what you're faced with today. But let me tell you, Jesus didn't turn his back on you. He's still with you today. He'll still help you through life's way. Things may have changed in your life. But let's pray that God will change these things for the better.
Amen, brother.
And what is the exceeding greatness? The power toward us who believe, according to the working of his mighty power. It's all about what he does. It's about what he can do today. We've seen people touched and healed. We've seen God do some things in some people's life right here inside this building. And you're going to keep on as long as you trust God. As long as we put God number one in our life today, we're going to see more things happen. Why? Because we serve a God. Hey, amen. He's powerful. It ain't about me. It ain't about, I'm not Benny Hinn. Say amen. I'm not one of those that walks up. I can knock you down if I wanted to, if I hit you hard enough in the forehead. That's not what it is. It's about anointing that person with oil, like it said in the book of James, and pray for them. Hey, the effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. It's about God and what God can do today. It's not about me. It's not what I can do. It's not me at all. It's God. Thank God there's some power. You realize the power that we have access. You got some power sitting in your lap. Say, man, that word of God, it's alive. It's living today. It's alive. Treat it like it's alive.
Amen, brother.
Treat it like it's God's holy word. Oh, listen. The Bible said, which he brought to Christ when he raised him from the dead and set him on his right hand in the heavenly places. Verse 24, far above all the principalities and power. Yeah. Thank God he raised him over everything. Thank God he's the victor over it all.
Yeah.
Hey, you need victory over some things in your life, then you need to talk to Jesus. He's the victor over everything. Every problem of life, he was the victor today. Death, he won.
Amen.
Hell,
yeah.
He won. Amen.
What
did he do? He came out of that grave. Thank God. God said, this isn't my plan.
Yeah.
My plan's my son's coming out of that grave in 3 days. You can't believe that? Then you can't believe that I'm preaching today. You came to the wrong church. But I'm telling you, it's about the blood of the Lamb of God. It's about Jesus Christ and him crucified. That's what it's all about. We're about that cross. Hey, he's not on that cross no more. Uh-huh. But it's a symbol to me to show me that I had somebody die on that old rugged cross. That blood that came streaming down. Yeah. A rugged cross. It was for my sin. It was for your sin. It was the sin for the entire world. Was covered by every drop of blood.
Amen.
It doesn't matter if it was from the crown of thorns. The Bible said they platted it on his head.
Come on, brother.
You know what that means? That means they put it on his forehead with force.
Right.
You ever had that? You ever walked by a sticker bush?
Yeah.
Little sissy sticker bushes, I call them. Until you see the crown of thorns. So the rose bush is a sissy bush. Because they're little bitty. The crown of thorns, the thorns are about 2 to 2.5 inches long. I stepped off the airport one day. Went on a business trip for my company. Was out in Arizona. Got off, seen a beautiful plant. Man, I just sitting there amazed at waiting on the guy to come pick me up from work. I just kept saying, some guy walked up and he said, you okay? I said, well, yeah. I said, I just kind of amused about that. I said, it's a beautiful plant. He said, don't touch it. I said, well, yes, sir. I thought it was government property. I said, whoa, you know, I ain't going to get shot over a plant. I'm just looking at it. But I sat there and I kept staring. He had a cane in his hand. He said, let me show you something. And under all that beauty, and all that beautiful stuff, he took that thing and picked those leaves up off that thing and those big old thorns in there. And they were razor sharp. Razor sharp. I said, is that what I think it is? He said, that's what they call the crown of thorns. Oh, honey. It started meaning something. I stared at it a little while longer after that. The beauty that it was to look at and the joy. And no doubt as a plant, it's a beautiful thing. Had a beautiful flowering on top of it. But deep down inside, it left some scar in my Savior's head. Amen? When they put that crown of thorns on his head and they took that reed out of his hand. And the Bible said they drove that thing down into the skull of my Savior. Let me tell you, there was some blood that came running out. Hey, if it just that drop of blood, that's all I needed. Say that. And that's all you needed. But the Bible said he shed every drop of blood from his hand, from his feet, and they even pierced his side. Every drop of blood came out from my Savior's side.
Come on, brother.
He did that for you today.
Preach it.
He did that because he loved you.
Amen.
My Bible said he could have called 10 legions of angels. That's 10,000 where I come from. Amen. That's an awful lot of angels. He could have called any one of them at any time and said, I'm done with this. Take me home. But did he? No. He said, nevertheless, not my will, but thy will be done. He said, I got to do what the Father said.
Yeah.
Me to
Amen.
Do. And that's exactly what he did.
Bless him, Lord.
And he did it for you today.
Preach it.
Oh, listen. The Bible said in Joel chapter 2, verse 26, and ye shall eat in plenty and be satisfied. Listen, and praise the name of the Lord our God. Amen? Praise the name of the Lord our God. God said, I'm going to bless you in Joel's day. Back in the Old Testament, God told him, he said, I'll bless you if you'll live for me. I'll bless your heart. I'll bless your life. And I'll bless your home.
Yeah.
And thank God to let him bless our church.
Yeah.
Amen. Hey, you're part of this church. God's going to bless you today. But the Bible said, who hath dealt with me wondrously, with you and my people, shall never be ashamed.
Come on, brother.
Has God ever done anything to shame you?
No.
He's not going to. My God will never do anything to put a shame and a reproach upon you. It might be an embarrassment to your friend that tell the dirty joke. It might be an embarrassment in front of them. But my God will not shame you in front of anybody. He's proven right here in this precious book of Joel chapter 2 verse 26. In the very last word, he shall never be ashamed. The people shall never be ashamed. You should never realize, know that God will never shame you today.
Bless you, Lord.
We've been through some things, haven't we? I've been through a lot of things today. But that don't mean anything. God's still on his throne. Isaiah chapter 25 verse 1 and 4 said, O Lord our God, I will exalt thee. I will praise thy name, for thou hast done wonderful things.
Yeah.
Hey, thy counsels of old, thy faithfulness and truth, for thou hast been a strength to the poor, a strength to the needy in distress, a refuge from the storm, a shadow from the heat, and the blast of the terrible one is like a storm against the wall. He said he's everything that you need. Whatever you're going through in your life, God can be what you need right now if you'll turn it over to him.
Amen.
The problem is, I'm going to fix this myself. It'll make me a smaller man if I can't. It'll make you less of a woman if you can't fix it for yourself. That's not what my Bible teaches, honey. My Bible said it's in the power of his mouth. It's in the power of God. God can do some things in your life if you'll loose the handcuffs off God and let God bless you. Hey, he can't bless you if you've got his hands tied today. He cannot bless you today. He said, far above the principalities and power and might and dominion, every name that is named, not only in this world, but also in the world which is to come. Thank God everything's covered under the blood of the Lamb of God. God's got this thing in your life today.
Amen, brothers.
The Bible said in verse 22, and hath put all things, he's put all things under his feet. That means if my Savior is walking with me and talking with me, like the song said, and he goes with me everywhere that I go, and he's always there, the Bible said if it's under his feet, guess what? It's under your feet too. Say that. If you're a child of God and you're trusting in the Lord, whatever you're faced with, whatever you're going through, God's walking with you. He's right there beside you. Whatever the Bible said, it's under his feet.
Amen.
That means it's under your feet too. But so many times, don't we?
Come on now.
I run into that wall.
Come on, brother.
Thinking I got the answer. Simple. Somebody locked the door on me and I didn't know it. I couldn't get out. What am I going to do? Question. God said, just reach down. God has the answer to whatever you're going through this morning.
Yes, he does.
Whatever that you're faced with in your life, God's got that thing in your life. Jeremiah 13:11 says, for as the girdle cleaveth to the loins of a man, have I not caused to cleave unto me the whole house of Judah? God said, I've made you a blessing. I'm going to bless your heart. I'm going to bless your life. I'm going to bless your city. I'm going to bless your country.
Yeah.
That's what America needs to do.
Yeah.
We need to go back to that place in Jeremiah where God said, as the girdle cleaveth to the loins of a man. In armor, that's what they put when they put the breastplate.
Right.
And the Lord played around. That's what kept the two together. That way nothing could get in there. Say that. Nothing could get inside that girdle. But thank God today what he told him. He said, I cause to cleave unto me the whole house of Judah, saith the Lord, that they might be unto me. Listen, for a people. Thank God I want to be God's people, don't you? I want God to be able to brag on me and say, that's one of my children right there. And your kid was playing ball and they made a good play. What'd you do? You got all excited. You yelled and screamed and hollered. Got all excited. We ought to do the same thing. I believe God's doing the same thing when you do something for him. When you get up and sing a song, even though you didn't feel like it. When you got up and done those things before God. When you got up and taught that Sunday school, I didn't feel very well, but I went ahead. God's going to bless you for what you've done.
Yeah, amen.
God will bless you. How many times have we done? Judah saith the Lord, that they might be unto me for a people. I want to be one of God's people. I just want to be part of the kingdom of God. I want to be one of God's children. That's simple today. That's very simple to change today. If you've never been saved, all you got to do is accept Jesus Christ. All you got to do is confess your sin before God. I'm not a TV preacher. It won't take me 15 minutes to pray this one. Amen. And it won't take you that long either. All you got to do is confess your sin. Lord, I'm sorry that I've sinned against you. Guess what? Ask Jesus Christ to come in and be Lord and Savior of your life.
Yeah.
Guess what happened? You've already been born again. Say, man, it's that simple today to be saved today.
Amen, brother.
Things can change in your life today.
Bless you, Lord.
The Bible said for me for a people. God chose me. God's chose you today.
Bless you.
God picked you for a reason. God made man for a reason. I believe God's an almighty God.
Yeah.
He's all-sufficient God.
Yeah.
And a God, all-knowing God.
That's right.
God knows your heart today.
Bless you, Lord.
He knows how you're hurting on the inside. He knows what's going on inside you. He already knows. Why don't you just turn it over to Him today? The Bible said He wants us to be a people. And for a name. Isn't that what Christian means? Christ-like.
That's right.
A name. I need to be what God called me to be.
Bless Him, Lord.
If I'm a Christian and I walk around telling people that I'm a Christian, then I need to start acting like
Amen.
One, talking like one,
Amen.
And being like, I said being like one. Hey, I need to be what God wants me to be.
Yeah.
It's not what the world standards put out. It's what God put out. It's why it's all about God today. And realizing I need to trust in my God more today than I ever have in my life. I need God in my life today. Show me, Lord, what you'd have me to do today. But the Bible said in the next part, He said, for a name and for a praise. You were made to praise God.
Right.
You know that?
Right.
That's what you were made for. That you can praise. God has angels that are all around His throne. All they know to sing is holy, 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 Lord God Almighty. That's the only song they
right.
know.
Amen.
But guess what? As a saint of God, I've got a different song. The Church of the Living God has got a different song to sing. Hey, when we get there, we can sing Amazing Grace.
Yeah.
The angels are going to sit there and scratch their head. They don't know about the Amazing Grace of God.
Amen.
It's always been. They've always been there. They already been worshiping God.
Right.
Shame on them. Amen. I'm going to beat them out one of these days. We're going to go and worship God in spirit and truth. Hey, for the next million years, we're going to be worshiping Him.
Right.
And honoring, glorifying Him.
Come on now.
The Bible said for a name and for a praise. But listen, and for a glory. And for the, hey, glory to God.
Yes.
Amen. Can you get that one today? Glory to God Almighty today for what He's done in our life. But here's the problem.
Come on, brother.
Here's the problem. The last three words, or five words, but they would not hear.
That's right.
They would not hear.
Come on, brother, preach it.
That old preacher gets up there and acts silly, don't he?
You,
spits all over everybody on the first three pews. I'm sorry. Do you know what? It's about loving the Lord.
Yeah, amen.
It's about loving God with all your heart. The book of Joel said, they would not hear. Don't care a thing about what you preached about, preacher.
Come on, brother.
One of these days when you stand before God, you've never been saved. You're going to remember this old preacher's ugly face.
That's exactly right.
You're going to remember this preacher's old ugly face. And you're going to remember when he preached that salvation message. Not interested. But in that day, it's going to be too late.
That's right, brother.
If you're not saved in this world to come, if death becomes you before, you stand before God. You're going to hear those words that breaks every man's heart. Depart from me, you workers of iniquity. I never knew you.
God help.
Oh my God, help us.
God.
Help us realize today salvation. Let's reach out with everything that we got. Pray every day.
Make that one of your main concerns in your prayer. Pray for mama and brother, sissy and daddy, amen. Pray for everybody else, but pray salvation for that sinner. That one that's lost and that's without God. They need salvation, because one of these days, when that trumpet sounds, the church of the living God is going to be taken out. I'm telling you, we're leaving this place. I'm taking me a plane air flight. I'm betting one I've never been on. Yes. I like going fast, don't you?
Yes.
Well, one of these days, I'm going to get my wish come true. I'm going to get that plane air flight. Hey, the Bible said in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, from here all the way to heaven, in just a blink of an eye. Hey, you can't even blink that fast. Blink as fast as you want to. You're already there. Say, man, that's how fast it's going to be.
That's right, brother.
The Bible said when the last breath is taken.
That's exactly right.
The last breath is taken. To be absent from the body. It's to be present with the Lord. Thank God today for those that have been born again. If you've never been saved, you better start putting it off. A little 14-year-old boy lived not too far from me several years ago. Hickson Junior High School, played football. He was athletic all of his life, played baseball. Had a major heart attack on the football field. He died at Hickson Junior High School. Never had another opportunity. Trying to scare you? I sure am. Because that's how fast death
comes.
Come
on, brother.
It comes.
Yeah.
You don't get a... Ask my aunt, she had a major heart attack, a massive heart attack. I asked her. I said, did you have a chance to ask Jesus to free? She said, I had a chance for nothing. She said, all I knew was the pain.
Come on, brother.
It was inside my heart. Let me tell you today, to know Jesus Christ today, it's a serious time right now. They come and get us a song ready for an invitational hymn today. They want to just play some, if he wants to sing a song.
Bless him.
We keep putting off.
Come on, brother.
I keep putting it off. Well, you know, there's going to come a better day. There's no better day than today.
That's right.
There's no better day today to get acquainted with the Son of God. To know Jesus Christ and to flee part of sin. How long have you put it off? Stop putting it off.
Yeah.
Stand with me all over the house. Every head bowed, every eye closed today. Do you know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior today? I didn't ask you how many years you've been going to church. I didn't ask if your mom and dad were saved. I asked you today, personally,
come on, brother.
Do you know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior? Because one of these days, you're going to take that one last breath. I sat and watched my mom take her last breath. One of these days, that last breath is coming to us all. It's appointed unto every man once to die. But then after that comes the judgment. You know what? Right after that last breath is taken, you're going to stand before God. And if you've never been saved, they'll say, depart from me, you workers of iniquity.
That's right.
I never knew you. Wouldn't you rather him open the doors and the hands and say, welcome. Come right on in. I'll be waiting on you.
Yep.
What a joy. But maybe you're sitting here today and you've never been saved. Maybe you need to search your heart today. Do you know Jesus Christ today as your personal Savior? You need to. Let's pray. Our Heavenly Father and our most holy God, we ask you, Father, right now. I pray that the Holy Ghost of God will reach up and down every heart, every life inside this building today. That we realize more than anything that we've been born again. That we know Jesus Christ in the free pardon of sin today. Father, we ask you to touch every heart, every man, woman, boy, and girl inside this building today. Father, we pray that you touch them. Let them realize right now, God, that they're in need of a Savior. Right now, convict that heart. Let them realize right now that they need Jesus right now in their life to make some changes in their life. Make some changes, Lord, in their future. I pray that God you bless right now. Have your way right now in this building. Bless every man, every woman, every boy, and every girl. Touch every heart right now. God, we pray. Whatever the need is right now, we know that our need can be so great. We ask you to touch that heart. That one has got a heavy burden this morning. That's all that they've been carrying. We ask you, Father, to touch them right now. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Have your way, Lord. Bless the service, God. We thank you for
you've already done, but we thank you for what you're going to do. Bless this service right now, Lord, we pray. Have your way right now. And God, I pray that you touch our heart, touch our life, touch this church today. Thank you for all that you've already done inside this building. But God, thank you for what you're going to do for the rest of this day and the rest of our life. I pray that you'll bless right now. Have your way in that one's heart that's not saved. If there's one today that don't know you, God, I pray that you deal with their heart until that day they accept you and give in to you, Lord. Have your way right now. Lead us now. Guide us and direct us today, Father, in the way that you have us to go. We'll be careful. We'll give you all the honor. We'll give you all the glory today. And God, we'll give you all the praise because it's in the precious name of Jesus Christ that we pray. Amen. Amen. I appreciate your time and attention this morning. Yes.
We have special prayer for Stephanie.
Yes. Sure can. Anyone else? All right. All the elders have come.
Everybody that believes in prayer, would you come with us? Heavenly Father, most
God, we come to you right now.
God,
we pray, God, right now.
Lord, you
know
our hearts more than anything.
Father, you know what you want.
I pray, Father, that you just touch his heart.
God, we know
what you want.
We ask you right now.
You know what it's all made up of.
You
just reach down the lips of your heart.
God, we know, Lord, that
you're our soul right now. And touch your God right now. In the name of Jesus,
right now.
Touch your Lord right now. Let it go right now. The hand of God. And lay down your life and her heart right now. Let her know we're going to shout her out as she's wrapped up in the love and the arms of our God. Lord, we love you today. We thank you for what you can do. Lord, we thank you for what you want to do today. And we ask you to have your way in this service right now. This is my precious heart today. Touch your God right now like only you can. Move in such a way she'll realize that it be the hand of an almighty God as we lay down upon her life and say, thank you, precious Lord, today for all that you've already done. God, we thank you for what you're going to do. We know some great mighty things for the children of God. I pray that you'll bless her heart. Bless her life right now, God. Special healing touch of God. The mercies of God today are laid down upon her heart and life. Touch her in Jesus' name. Oh, God, bless her, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, thank you, Jesus. Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Our service today, please, sir.
I appreciate all the fathers to come to you once again, Lord. I love you and I thank you, Father, for your many blessing life. Thank you, Lord, for the service we had today. Thank you, Father,
yes,
for this thing. Come, dear Father, I pray, Lord, that you'd touch her body. I pray, Lord, for these that are out sick. Father, I pray, God, you'd be with them. Hold them up, dear Father, I pray right now, God, in your